Papua New Guinea is warning more than 2,000 people could be buried alive after a large landslide devastated a village in the country's north. Joining me live is Care International PNG Country Director Justine McMahon. Thanks for your time. It's the inaccessibility of this area, and I guess from what we've seen, the way some of the housing is built as well, that seems to have led to such a wide-scale disaster.
Definitely. The houses are made out of bush materials, which would not withstand a small landslide, if there's such a thing, but certainly nothing to the scale we saw on Friday. I think the other factor that contributed to the situation is the time it occurred, which was 3 a.m, when everyone was asleep.
Yeah, sitting at home. In terms of the assistance available, the reports we're getting is the New Zealand government's ready and willing with a package, Australia as well, obviously two close, important neighbours, but they can't do it unilaterally. Is there any sense of frustration that the PNG government hasn't ticked off on things or made it clear what they need?
The international community, Australia, New Zealand, the US, a number of other governments immediately offered assistance. They're respectful of the government processes, and they will wait until the PNG government has gone through the proper protocols and ticked everything off, and then a formal request for assistance will be made.
Yeah, the ongoing situation there as well in terms of the stability of the government, I guess, is a bit of a concern. We've got this no confidence motion among things such as fuel security and law and order. Is there any sense that's hampering rescue efforts?
The law and order, Enga, unfortunately, has experienced really violent tribal fights and is still experiencing them in different areas. However, in the affected area, there's a very strong presence of the Defence Force. I think that will mitigate any trouble for the moment. The fuel, the aviation fuel, is disrupting travel around the country, and potentially that may also be getting supplies into Mount Harvey, the nearest largest airport. The vote of no confidence, yes, it's an unknown quantity, really. It's on tomorrow. We're hoping that there will be stability, but it's very much a wait-and-see situation.
So your organisation obviously poised to help. Is there anything anyone else can do at this difficult time?
A number of organisations are already responding. Care has been asked by the district administration to provide food, water and hygiene supplies, which we will do. That will be up there in a few days. That's the funding, the initial funding, smaller amount of funding we received from the Australian government through the Australian Humanitarian Partnership Mechanism. Other governments, the UN, are already on the ground, and relief supplies were delivered over the weekend.
Justine McMahon, appreciate your time today. Thank you.